Hello friends, today's topic of discussion is Environmental Performance Index 2018. Relevance of this topic with respect to RBI Grade B will be in Phase 1, General Awareness, Phase 2, Paper 2, Economic and Social Issues under Sustainable Development and Environmental Issues. With respect to NABARD, Grade A will be in Phase 1, Economic and Social Issues, Phase 2, Paper 2, Economic and Social Issues under Sustainable Development and Environmental Issues. Environmental Performance Index, that is EPI 2018, is released on 23rd January 2018, which measures how close countries come to meet the targets for core environmental policy categories. Very important to remember that it is a biennial report that is released after every 2 years and is produced by researchers at Yale and Columbia Universities of USA in collaboration with World Economic Forum. I again repeat to remember the institutions which produce this report. This slide shows all the parameters which are measured by EPI, like rate of alternate energy use, ability to integrate economic and human development with sound natural resource management, quality of life instead of economic growth, etc. It will give you a broad idea about the areas covered by EPI. Now question comes, how Environmental Performance Index is calculated? EPI 2018 is calculated by aggregating data gathered from 24 individual metrics of environmental performance into 10 major issue categories, which are shown here. Remember the names of all these 10 categories. Also, remember their subsequent indicators like under air quality, solid fuels and PM2.5 is covered. Under heavy metals, only lead is covered. Under air pollution, sulfur dioxide and NOx is covered, etc. As explained in earlier slide, firstly, the 24 individual metrics are aggregated into 10 major environmental issue categories, which are further divided into two policy objectives, that is, environmental health and ecosystem vitality, which measures threats to human health, and the other one measures natural resources and ecosystem services. Ecosystem vitality has around 60% weightage in calculation of overall environmental performance index covering 7 issue categories, that is, biodiversity and habitat, forest fisheries, climate and energy, air pollution, water resources and agriculture. On the other hand, environmental health has 40% weightage covering only 3 issue categories, that is, air quality, water and sanitation and heavy metals. Finally, the data is rescaled into 0 to 100 score, and higher score indicates long-standing commitments to protecting public health, reducing greenhouse emissions, etc. This slide shows a quick overview of previous two slides. The respective indicators and issues belonging to each policy objective is shown here. Remember the name of all 10 issue categories and their respective policy objectives. As seen in the picture, few questions that can come in exam like air quality covers maximum weightage under environmental health. On the other hand, climate and energy has maximum weightage in ecosystem vitality. Under heavy metals, 100% weightage is given to lead exposure, and remember all those indicators where 100% weightage is given to a single indicator. No need to remember the names of other indicators. Top 5 countries as per EPI 2018 are Switzerland, France, Denmark, Malta, Sweden, and bottom 5 countries are Nepal, India, Democratic Republic of Congo, Bangladesh, and the last country is Burundi. Details of India getting such a lower rank is explained in later section. Another important country is Seychelles, which ranked as the most improved country over the past decade. This slide shows the quick summary of what is explained till now. Go through each point and remember the important ones. As explained earlier, the two policy objectives, that is environmental health and ecosystem vitality, constitutes an overall environmental performance index. Environmental health has a score of 31.50 and ecosystem vitality has 55.93 with overall environmental protection score of 46.16, which is still far from achieving international targets. As compared to baseline period, ecosystem vitality has increased more than environmental health, indicating that gains from efforts to protect dimension of ecosystem vitality is more impactful than environmental health. As explained in earlier slide, the policy objective of environmental health has a score of 31.5 points, that is an increase of 3.34 points as compared to baseline. Among its issue categories, air quality is the biggest threat to public health. Water and sanitation require more efforts, and regulation pertaining to heavy metals are quite impactful in limiting exposure from petrol and paint, etc. Talking about second policy objective, that is ecosystem vitality, it has score of 55.93 points with the increase of 5.25 points from baseline. Among its issue categories, there are improvement in biodiversity and habitat, climate and energy, and air pollution. Fisheries shows decline due to overfishing, and forest fires, illegal logging, etc. continues to threaten forest habitat in the world. Important thing to remember that water resources is the only issue category of ecosystem vitality whose global performance in wastewater treatment hasn't changed from the baseline due to unavailability of data. In agriculture, despite of huge efforts, there is very small improvement over the past decade. Picture shows some important key findings of Environmental Performance Index 2018. Go through each of them. Let's talk about India's position in Environmental Performance Index 2018. India has ranked 4th worst performing country by securing 177th rank among 180 countries in EPI 2018. Among all the 10 issue categories, worst position is in air quality category, as it has score of just 5.75 out of 100. India's low rank indicates urgent attention towards cleaning up air quality, protecting biodiversity, and reduce greenhouse gas emissions. MCQs are for practice and are based on the content discussed so far. Kindly solve them for better understanding.
Thank you and happy learning.